living talking, and it can cost you a job.
Yeah.
It's not just unpleasant. It's when it's going to cost you a career or a job because you say the wrong thing.
You got to watch out.
A bunch of elitists in the ruling class throwing a little bone to who they deem to be the lower class. Yeah, we'll do something about that. That's all it is.
But that's what before the break, that what he was saying when that guy was talking to me, that's the thing. White people are doing this to everybody. There's, like, if a black person says white, the thing that bothers me sometimes is that, look, we're not talking about just the dudes, the garbage men, the guy you bump to into in the elevator. There's a white guy that we just named white that does bad things to everybody, and they're willing to take white people's rights away just to get that overall big brother thing going.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what it is. It's just like nobody black is stopping language, but no one black is ever like who run,
Jesse
Colin Sharpton. Powell's son ran the FCC, but no. he wasn't making the decisions.
He was terrible.
He really was.
Come on, man.
Patrice, he was terrible.
Yeah.
He was terrible.
I know he was terrible, but I'm saying he wasn't making decisions. I'm saying. So,
it was the machine, man.
Above him. That's what y'all have to deal with. Like you said,
the Illuminati.
That's what you got to deal with is you can't say stuff that you could say in the 60s. Shut up.
That's great if I'm a garbage man, but the fact that I talk for a living and I talk on the radio and I'm going to get dumped out of saying something,
yeah.
Or that's where it gets frustrating. I understand the overall picture.
It affects us differently because living, we can lose this. Yeah, yeah.
But that's
when
why
they tell me I can't say it in my car, then I got a problem because...
Or on TV, you can't do certain jokes.
That was my thing with Imus. The stance I took is that as a black performer, I really have no language barriers. I can say pretty much what I want.
Sure.
And so for anybody black not to defend somebody who talks for a living when they eventually they will come after me and say I can't say what I feel like saying, sure. And I don't even know how to not do that. You know, I don't know how to not do it, so mm-hmm. I'll be in trouble.
But as far as black people not fighting to repress language, Jackson, Sharpton, somebody who actually works very high up at CBS, that stupid Whoopi Goldberg, Al Roker, Snoop, they all went after him, all talk for a living, and they all wanted him removed for saying something they knew he said in humor. None of them call out a guy like Jesse for saying something he means. Like no one calls him out. Saying something under your breath is who you really are.
Right.
When you're caught on a microphone saying something, that's the way you feel.
And it boils down to double standard. I'll do it. I'll take it. I'll say it. It is what it is. But we, you know, black people get to deal with double standard. We had to deal with double standard in terms of breathing. Like, what are you talking about?
True. It is what
if
it is.
White people can make us breathe different air, you would. It's like, you can't say, shut up. Shut your face. It is a double standard.
It is, but I don't want to be affected by it because it can cost me everything, and that's what makes me sick. I don't care about it as an overall thing. I don't want it to cost me my job.
Yeah, let's go to Phil in New York. Phil?
How's it going, O'Neal? Mm-hmm.
Phil Connors? What do you got, Phil?
Well, it's just like, take if you saw, like, John McCain at his home and you heard something like, oh, John McCain hates Americans. Like, Jesse Jackson has a public image that he's trying to portray, and he just went completely against it.
Well, look at all the crap Dog the Bounty Hunter got for a private conversation. Look at Charlie Sheen had to come out and Dog the Bounty Hunter was fired for saying unpopular things on a phone message with his son. And I know that was an angry thing, but privacy is not always kept private. It's fraudulent. It's more than just an inconvenient double standard.
But I'm going to give you something too that white people don't have that black people do have. And again, I don't have an argument for why it's right or wrong. Black people have a black thing. Like, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, we hear
like,
it's we, huge.
I hear you have a black thing, man. It's just like. That black people will listen to that and go, I get it. And white people will be too afraid to attack it on the level of what it is, where black people can go, we do that. But white people don't have a thing that, white people do. But that's a human thing to talk trash about somebody behind their back.
Yeah, it might be a human thing, but that doesn't mean it's right.
I didn't say it was right.
But it's fine that he did it. I have no problem with Jesse Jackson saying that, and I really don't think he should have gotten in trouble for it. I just want him to shut his mouth when it comes to somebody else saying something. That's it.
There you go.
Don't ask him
now he really doesn't have a leg to stand on.
That's all I'm saying. But it doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. He didn't have a leg to stand on after Jaime Town. People let it go.
He said it was taken out of context.
He said, I only meant Jews. People are like, oh, okay.